Here's the basics of Smart Notebook. First of all, you have this navigation area up here. This is kind of your main area for selecting tools. You start out with your clicker or your arrow. Pens, when you click pens, it brings up all the different colors and a few other objects. You can choose pen styles, highlighters, magic pen, create pen. There's a whole bunch. We can go into all that later. Different colors that you want to choose. Patterns and size or thickness of your line. And this over here is transparency. Then over here, let's see, text options to choose what font, sizes, centered, color, and transparency as well. Lines, if you're choosing different types of lines, you can choose with arrows, like array. Dotted lines, one with arrows on both sides, diamonds, colors, a lot of different options. You can kind of select here as well, like if you want one end to be a dot and the other to be an arrow, or you can customize it however you'd like. Let's see. Shapes. This is kind of a nice thing if you want a very specific shape and you want it done well. You can choose any of these and you'll be able to draw those out there. There is a drop down for a lot of these where you get just additional options. Color, same thing. It seems pretty similar for most of these. This is kind of a nice one when you're teaching geometric shapes because you can draw exactly and it tells you how many sides each object has. It's really handy. Once again, colors and lines. The fill box, this is a good one, but with this one, just so you know, you can only fill completed objects, which are with the shape tools or with lines. If you draw something and try and fill it, it won't work. Unless I'm doing a tutorial, then it will. But usually it won't. Let's see what else. Over here, you've got this is kind of your work panel. You can customize this, choose what you'd like there by coming over here to Tools. If you want something there, you can drag it up here and it'll add it to it. If you want to get rid of something, you can always pull it out. So you can customize that. The screen options, this is really nice to see how large you want your screen, if you want it zoomed in or zoomed out. You can just automatically set it to entire page width, so it's a nice little setting. Dual page, if you want two pages up at once, makes it kind of nice to scroll through. A few pages. Full screen gets rid of everything except for this cool little tool manager, and you can exit by clicking back on the screen. You can open files or save files. If you don't like a page and you're ready to get rid of it, let's do it to the next one. You can click X and it'll get rid of it. If you want to add a blank page, click the plus. And over here is kind of your work panel. This kind of your shows you all the different pages that are on this slide. When you start a new one, it'll only have the one. The gallery, this is where you can get your images, some of your interactive activities that are already created. Attachments, this is where you can work on your fonts, text, color. Not a lot of options right now. And then your activity builder, really fun to work on, a little more complicated. But it's really, really cool. Another thing down here, you can select auto hide or not. If you deselect it, then that'll stay open and you can see everything while you're working. I usually like to have a little more room to work on my board, so I'll do auto hide, and then when I'm done with it, it just automatically closes. So that looks to me like pretty much the main basics. One last thing, this drop down, if you're working on a smart board and maybe you have shorter students, if you click that, it actually puts the toolbar on the bottom. It's a nice way for them to be able to access it. If you don't want that, you can always leave it up at the top.
Hey teacher, it's the techno rebel.
Oh.
Hey teacher, it's the techno rebel.
Oh.